nations need energy for fueling the dreams of its people. India hardly produced any oil at independence. 200 years of colonial rule had left an indelible scar on the economy and the people. The country needed rapid growth and expansion, and energy had been the cornerstone. Importing oil was deadly expensive. There was no alternative but to find oil. The Western oil experts had proclaimed India didn't have oil. Undaunted, India decided to pursue exploration. August 14, 1956. The dream of self-reliance of energy took form in the shape of Oil and Natural Gas Commission, led by Pandit Keshav Dev Malviya. A handful of oil soldiers began the journey. The journey of quest. The journey of responsibilities, resilience and realization of dream. The initial drilling at Jwalamukhi, Himachal Pradesh did not fructify. But our oilmen remained undaunted. They were confident. Their aspiration was unbridled. It was Assam and Gujarat which were next destination. In Assam, oil-smeared elephants' hoof marks had led to discovery of first oil in 1889. ONGC undertook drilling in Western India at Cambay. To India's delight, the efforts paid off. 5th of September 1958, ONGC tasted its first success in a span of 25 months when oil started flowing at Lanage. Soon, ONGC began drilling successfully in Ankleshwar, Vadodara, Ahmedabad, Mehsana, and later at Aliabet in Gujarat. Simultaneously, a rig was positioned at well number TS1 at Disangmo. The explorers were on the trail. They set out, armed with the spirit to serve the nation's cause. The prologue to this journey comprised of a zillion battles. The weather, the logistics, the communication facilities, the terrain, the infrastructure, and the rationed finances all posed obstacles larger than one another. Each had to be and was tackled in a novel way. The taste of success came at the second well drilled at Disangmukh, and it was time to celebrate by the banks of the Brahmaputras. The horizons had expanded. The toil began paying dividends. Something tacit about these men posted at the far-flung locations also kept the ONGC flag flying high.
My wife, my children, they lived in tents, faced storms, rains, the tents would collapse. There would be sandstorms in Rajasthan or Kutch. They faced with me all these things and became partners of ONGC's work, ONGC's success.
Another element key to the pursuits was the willingness to adopt technology. The feelers of offshore at Aliabet spurred the explorers. Soon with the Russian ship Akademik Akhangishki, exploration commenced in Bombay offshore. Positive indications eased the decision to purchase the drill ship Sagar Samrat in 1973. 3rd February 1974, drilling commenced at offshore. Under 3 weeks, oil was struck at offshore. In a record 28 months, it was tabbed for production. Celebrations followed. A giant gas field was also discovered in 1976 at Basin, followed by large discoveries of Hira and Neelam in 1977 and 1987 respectively. ONGC was riding a crest.
We have used all sorts of things, hired donkeys somewhere to transport equipment, somewhere carried ourselves. We did take risks. The whole focus was to produce results.
Other onshore assets also came up like Rajahmundry in South Central and Karaikal in the down south. A major find, the Krishna Godavari or the KG block, was discovered in the deep waters of the east coast in the Bay of Bengal. This asset is estimated to be by far the most prolific of the newer finds, expected to produce first gas by 2019 and first oil by 2020. The journey, which started with a team of 60 vanguards, has now grown into a retinue of 31,000 plus oil soldiers. From a first budget of rupees 4 crores, it has transformed into a company of a turnover of more than rupees 1,09,655 crores in financial year 2018-19.
The one word that comes to my mind when I think about my experience in ONGC's adventure.
It gives me immense pride that I'm doing something nice for the nation. I'm contributing to the nation, which was not possible but to join an ONGC.
Here we work as a family. It's a people's organization.
ONGC, and in particular offshore, has made me a better version of myself.
From Assam to Cambay, from Jammu to Karaikal, and from Jaisalmer to KG Basin, ONGC has spread its wings. It had ventured offshore in 1965 with its subsidiary Messrs Hydrocarbons India Limited, later rechristened as ONGC Videsh Limited or OVL in 1988. With footprints across the globe, OVL now spans 41 projects in 20 countries. ONGC believes in transformation, and it constantly drives the spirit of change. From a small department, it transformed into an E&P major in first 3 decades. Discover and produce has been the mantra behind these transformation process. ONGCians travel where perhaps angels fear to tread. It has discovered 6 of the 7 oil producing basins. 2 more new basin prospects have come up in the last financial year. One of the landmark milestones is acquisition of HPCL. With this acquisition, ONGC is now the largest integrated oil company of the country. ONGC is today chasing the molecule from sedimentary basin to refinery, well to wire, from kitchen to sky. There is ONGC in every moment of life. What started as a directorate became a commission to a corporate, from an aspiration to an astounding energy powerhouse. In order to expand energy horizon, ONGC has ventured into unconventional hydrocarbons, CBM, shale and gas hydrates. Scripting a new era, ONGC is exploring alternate energy like wind and solar power. What began on treacherous terrain was consolidated through streets of struggle and onto the highway of prosperity. ONGC is today the largest integrated oil company of the country, having strong presence in the entire hydrocarbon value chain. It is also one of the largest spenders in the CSR front. ONGC, it is an equal opportunity employer. 64 years and going strong.